Trauma of what happened, combined with the effects of the medicine, spurred the loss of your memories. But now you remember the horror in full detail. Sobbing, you gather Mar in your arms. Melanie, Riddis, and Bruno just stand there in silence, absorbing the truth of your origin. Melanie, who knows all too well the pain of losing your parents, we have a lot in common, you and I. That's how we've made it this far together, she says softly. Moved by her kindness, you give her but I've still got farther to go. You, as painful as those memories are, if you can get your hands on an undiluted solution of dragon tear, you can restore Mar to her human form. And what was that about the place they called the mausoleum? That's probably a good enough place as any to start. Melanie doesn't miss the determination that blooms on your face. Whatever it is you need to do, she says, I'm with you. Giant boulder impedes the path. Who do you see but the ivory-ordered trio? In a flash, you draw your weapons, but Hedwyn calls out, wait. Unlike the other times you've crossed paths, the trio doesn't seem keen on fighting you. You lower your weapons in response. Conveniently, you've got some questions for the minifig. Demand to know what the Ivory Order wants. There's no reason to hide it any longer, begins. He tells you of the immense fortune the Order amassed by selling the medicine they forced the dragon to make on this island. And he confirms recapturing the dragon was the Order's true goal. The dragon's imprisonment on this island was a secret only the upper echelons of the Order were privy to. Even Queen Nilla didn't know. You ask where the mausoleum is. Coincidentally, says Hedwyn, atop the volcano, Sherwin swore to destroy that place. Winifred ponders the question of why Sherwin would betray the Order and kill the dragon. Alas, we cannot get to the mausoleum with this in our way. Hedwyn's. Upon closer examination of the bolt, perhaps it was weakened by the earthquake caused by the volcano erupting. With the right approach, you might be able to force your way through after all. You ask Bruno to put his brawn to use. He squares off in front of the giant stone and strikes the fissure with a mighty knife-edged chop. Silence rings for a moment. Before the boulder crumbles to dust. The Ivory Order trio offers a curt thanks before hurrying on ahead. The jerks. come across two men sitting on a rock. You listen in. Lean stashed the goods away. That island shaped like a ride in the dragon's nostril. It sounds like the dragon's nostril. Your perseverance pays off. You come to learn that the island itself is shaped not unlike the dragon's head. You hastily grab a scrap of paper, write down what you've heard, and quietly sneak away. Watch out, your friends cry, as something you keep you cool. Your friends gasp as you catch whatever it is before it clobbers you.
Thank you.
spot a sign standing prominently on the cape. This sign reads, "Strike the Stealer somewhere on this island." Oh yeah? What will happen if you do, you wonder? About the enemy. Bizarre rock transformed into a gold rock. Lucky. A monster appears. It hesitates, lurching toward you, then away. And was that the monster you helped earlier coming back to say thanks? I'd like to think so. The party makes a meal of the fish. You found a steel. You try gently knocking on it, as if to test its solidity. You swear you feel a rumble coming from the east. A stela stands before you. There's a message engraved on the stela. It reads, "You see another island across the sea. Why striking a stela would allow you to cross?" You give the stela a solid thwack. Not a moment later, the entire party begins to levitate. Before you know it, a strange power without warning, an old man leaps from. He sidles up to you. "Mind living on this here island in my stead?" he offers cloyingly. course it is, he shouts, leaping toward you. Rout the enemy. Nice work. island is cursed, the hermit explains, and he along with it. Doomed to spend eternity here, unless he finds someone to take his place. Defeated, the old hermit sinks where monsters suddenly appear from who knows where. They surround the dejected old man and let out bitter cries of lament. Come to console me, have you? He quietly nods, rises.
The island gets as lonely as I do.
You had better leave, the hermit says softly. And you feel yourself begin to levitate once more. Has he chosen to remain on the island after all? Is that what this is about? The party finds themselves back on the cape. The stela that once rose from the sand is nowhere to be found. You turn your gaze toward the hazy, solitary island in the distance. Farewell, you say quietly into the wind.
Wake me up when you need me.
Yeah.
The woman stares blankly into the distance. At her feet lie dozens of empty medicine bottles. Thank you.